Alleluia, alleluia, Christ has risen from the dead. He has risen to die no more. At the dawn of Easter morning, when the stones was rolled away, then from the darkness rose in glory, Jesus Christ to risen life, writing all the earth's dark night. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ has risen from the dead. He has risen to die no more.
Good morning, dear brothers and sisters.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. This Mass is offered for the following intentions. Thanksgiving Mass offered by Dr. Jivaratnam and Monica family. These intentions and the personal intentions, let us pray in this Holy Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit is with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, on Saturdays we do commemorate the importance of Mother Mary. Mother Mary participated in the history of salvation, and she accepted and she said yes to the Lord. As a result, a Savior had come in this world, and we are free from clutches of sins and darkness. Mother Mary keeps interceding for us. Let us pray to Mother Mary and ask Mother Mary to intercede her Son. What are the prayers and petitions? So that Mother Mary do intercede for us and grant all our prayers and petitions for the intercession of her. Sincerely ask pardon and mercy where we are gone astray from the Lord. Participate in this Holy Eucharistic celebration in a worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, and in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do,
through my faults,
through my faults,
through my most grievous faults.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Kindly take Mass 109. Lord have mercy on our soul. Lord have mercy on us. Lord have mercy on us. Lord have mercy on us. Christ have mercy on us. Christ have mercy on us. Christ have
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who through the regenerating power of baptism have been pleased to confer on us heavenly life, grant, we pray, that those you render capable of immortality by justifying them may by your guidance attain the fullness of glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
For the first reading, please take page number 135 of the New Testament. The first reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16, verses 1 to 10, on page number 135 of the New Testament. Paul came also to Derbe and to Lystra. A disciple was there named Timothy, the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. He was well spoken of by the brethren at Lystra and Iconium. Paul wanted Timothy to accompany him, and he took him and circumcised him because of the Jews that were in those places, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they went on the way through the cities, they delivered to them for observance the decisions which had been reached by the apostles and the elders who were at Jerusalem. So the churches were strengthened in the faith, and they increased in numbers daily. And they went through the region of Phrygia and Galatia, having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. And when they had come opposite Mysia, they attempted to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So, passing by Mysia, they went down to Taurus, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. A man of Macedonia was standing besieging him and saying, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." And when he had seen the vision, immediately we sought to go on into Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsory psalm is taken from Psalm 100, verses 1 to 5, and our response to the psalm. Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him singing for joy. Our response?
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Know that he, the Lord, is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock. Our response?
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Indeed, how good is the Lord. Eternal his merciful love, faithful from age to age. Our response?
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Acclamation.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
If you have been raised with Christ, seek things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 15, verses 18 to 21, on page 110 of the New Testament. If the world hates you, be aware that it hated me before it hated you. If you belong to the world would love you as its own, because you do not belong to the world. But I have chosen you out of the world. Therefore, the world hates you. Remember the words that I said to you. Servants are not greater than their master. If they persecuted me, they will persecute you. If they kept my words, they'll keep yours also. But they will do all these things to you on account of my name, because they do not know him who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today's topic is very important and is very emotional. Hatred. How can we understand this hatred? For example, in particular place, a particular group is dominating, it has its own identity. Somebody else comes and does good works and tries to occupy their space. People who are enjoying the identity, popularity, suddenly when their popularity and identity gets diminished, these people try to attack the person who is trying to occupy the space. Same way, Jesus is speaking in today's gospel. Jesus doesn't belong to this world. Jesus belongs to heavenly world. This world belongs to Satan. When good comes, good tries to occupy this earth, Satan doesn't allow. Satan or this world try to diminish, try to attack, try to throw this goodness from this world to nowhere. Once group of missionaries had come to Orissa. They were running a leprosy center. They were extremely doing well. Since there were more people who are suffering from leprosy, they wanted to have more house. They have been getting funds from foreign. They were doing wonderfully well. Slowly, people have been getting converted. People have been attending masses. People have been attending different services. Good is trying to occupy this another space. The fundamentalists decided to kill the missionaries. And they did hatred. When things go to another extreme, people go mad, the hatred comes. When emotionally disturbed, people can take another extreme decision. And they came, group of fundamentalists came, and they locked missionaries in the jeep, and they poured fuel on it, and they burned them alive. This is called hatred. And one more incident in Orissa only, in Kandamal. Only because of hatred, only because people have been following Christianity, following the footsteps of Lord Jesus Christ. Fundamentalists came and attacked simple people, lay people. They raped nuns, they killed priests. Only because of hatred. Hatred has no place. In a sense, good has no place in this world. When good comes, hatred are people who are fundamentalists, people who have been occupied by others, they'll try to chase them out. Jesus beautifully telling, if the world hates you, be aware that it hated me before it hated you. Jesus came. Jesus has a dual nature. He is a fully human and fully divine. As a human being, he started moving with sinners. He was dining with the sinners. People started hating Jesus. How can the person who have been claiming is a rabbi can move with the sinners, prostitutes and all sorts of things which has people have no identity in the society? Always we go with the stigma, the identity. I am great, I am something supreme. Yes, my dear brethren, we human beings belong to this world, always tries to get the highest position. We human beings are selfish beings. When somebody comes and occupies, will try to take revenge, try to put others down, is called hatred. Jesus is telling, if you want to be my disciple, follow my footsteps. Jesus had given the golden rule, love your neighbor as yourself. Whoever may be, clearly tells, this world doesn't belong to us, but good has to be proclaimed. When we started proclaiming the goodness, a good towards the society, be aware, be alert, ready to face the consequence. Anybody, anyone can attack. Remember, when you do all these things, you will be remembered in heaven. That's what scripture has been telling. Whatsoever you do to the least of my brethren, that you do unto me. Keep doing good. What are the consequences we do face? Just love the society. Amen.
Except Almighty Father, this bread of bread and wine, which not the priest offered for us before thy shrine, but serve the word is worthy and is loved, the sacrifice renewing, once offered on the cross. May this altar unworthy some offering we will pay. But only half the givers, then won't the givers stay? Our hearts, our souls, our senses, we give to Mary's hand, who by the cross was standing, now by the altar stands.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices into your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and that of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We'll lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as a Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Mass 109. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of might and power, glory filled all ever earth, sing to him, Hosanna. to Kolkata. Bringing this great glory, praise and honor be to God, sing to Him, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." No mystery of faith,
we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bala, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Antimony Paul, Dominic John, Joseph Thomas, and Amala Thomas, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles, all the saints who are pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, what in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Make me a servant, humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and may the prayer of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today. Even though you were in the form of God, you took the form of the slave. You lived to death, even on a cross, so God exalted your name. Make me a servant, humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and may the prayer of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today. You flung me in my mother's womb. You called me by my name, and you touched my mouth and appointed me a prophet to the world. Make me a servant, humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and may the prayer of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me.
Father, I pray for them that they may be one in us, so that the world may believe it was you who sent me, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is celebrated. Go and glorify the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. 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 Can you take hymn number 499?
499. I'll sing a hymn to Mary, the Mother of my God, the Virgin of all virgins, of David's royal blood. Oh, teach me, Holy Mary, a loving soul to pray, when we must feel thee. I love and bless thy name, O lily of the valley, O mystic rose bud tree, or flower in the fairest, is half so fair as thee. Let me know so lowly, recite my